Hello and welcome to the Center of Excellence training series on TAC. In this tutorial, we will cover two examples of importing GeoPDFs into TAC, including sourcing USGS map quads and incident action plan maps. Let's get started. The U.S. Geological Survey has an easy-to-use website tool for downloading map quads. In your search bar, type NGMDB. Click National Geologic Map Database, then select TopoView from the bottom toolbar. On the top toolbar, select Get Maps. Either zoom and tap an area of interest on the map, or type a location into the search bar. When you find an area of interest, the name of the quad will appear with several options, including when the map was made. We recommend clicking the Show button to confirm the map version selected is what you actually want to use. Sometimes the thumbnails to the right of the map version aren't very clear. Be attentive to the map scale, as most people will want to use the traditional 1 to 24,000 scale. Others, such as 1 to 100,000, may not provide enough detail to be useful. To download, click the GeoPDF button and save it to your device. Most will choose the download folder. This works in WinTAC, ATAC, or iTAC. For iTAC, tap the Layers button, then Overlays, the plus button, then Local Device, and choose the file. For WinTAC and ATAC, use the Import tool in the main menu and select the map file. Image overlay file will overlay the GeoPDF on your existing base map, whereas imagery will use the GeoPDF as a base map. To toggle the image overlay file on or off, navigate to Overlays, then Image Overlays. To toggle the imagery option, navigate to the Trifold Map tool, then click Maps and PDF. For iTAC, use Layers, then Overlays to toggle. To download a map from an incident action plan, begin by scanning the QR code on the first page of the document. Select Maps, the desired day, and the desired map. Download the maps to your device and complete the same steps for importing the maps onto your TAC device. This concludes our tutorial for downloading offline GeoPDFs, powered by the Colorado Department of Public Safety and the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting. Thanks for watching.